Hello, everyone. Welcome to Engineering Today, and we have three latest and exciting news for you. Let us begin with SpaceX SpheRex contract with NASA. SpaceX won a NASA contract again. NASA awarded a contract to SpaceX for the launch of the SpheRex spacecraft aboard a Falcon 9 in mid-2024. The launch contract, worth $98.8 million, which includes the launch of itself and other mission-related costs. SpheRex, which stands for Spectrophotometer for the History of the Universe, Epoch of Reunionization, and ICE's Explorer, is destined to perform study of hundreds of millions to billions of stars and galaxies all around the universe. SpheRex's primary objective is to better grasp and compute the state of the universe, specifically the Big Bang. The space telescope will also help to find out the presence of water or ice throughout the Milky Way. According to scientists, it will help to find out the role that ice plays in formation of planet and other astral objects. On the 5th of February 2021, SpaceX tweeted, after getting the NASA contract, that Falcon 9 will launch NASA's SpheRex mission, which will collect data on more than 300 million galaxies, and explore how the universe began, from our launch site at Vandenberg Air Force Base, as early as June 2024. In January, SpheRex conducted Phase C of its development procedure. The mission was originally scheduled to launch in 2023. Jet Propulsion Laboratory, which manages SpheRex, said in January 2021 that the mission is now rescheduled to launch between June 2024 and April 2025. Partially, the delay was caused by the effects of the COVID-19 pandemic. Keeping an eye on specifications, we will see SpheRex is a small spacecraft weighing less than 200 kilograms. SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket readily excels such a payload of small weight and is capable of delivering at least 5 to 10 metric tons to SpheRex's targeted orbit. NASA may use the excess space of SpaceX Falcon 9 for launching smallsat secondary payloads as rideshare missions. The Interstellar Mapping and Acceleration Probe of National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, which is scheduled to launch in 2025, will include NASA's Global Lyman Alpha Imagers of the Dynamic Exosphere, Lunar Trailblazer and Solar Cruiser SmallSat missions, and the Space Weather Follow-on L1 spacecraft. This $98.8 million launch contract is also a relatively expensive Falcon 9 launch contract. After winning contracts of this worth from NASA and other companies are now almost a routine for SpaceX. According to the U.S. Government Accountability Office, NASA had reserved $120 million for SpheRex's launch contract. Winning the contract only for nearly $99 million, SpaceX likely saved more than $21 million of NASA in competing with the cheapest possible alternative, ULA's Atlas V rocket. Building the SpheRex will cost about $242 million. With launch costs included, the SpheRex mission is now expected to cost NASA approximately $340 million. SpaceX has been awarded many contracts from NASA in the last 2 years. SpheRex contract is the latest of the series of awards. SpaceX had won an $80.4 million contract to launch NASA's $900 million PACE Oceanography Observatory on a Falcon 9 rocket in the same year as SpheRex. Previous awards comprises of $106 million NASA contract to launch the $750 million Interstellar Mapping and Acceleration Probe Space Science Mission, a $50 million contract to launch the $140 million Imaging X-ray Polarimetry Explorer Astrophysics Satellite Mission, a $69 million contract to launch NASA's $250 million Double Asteroid Redirection Test Planetary Defense Mission, and SpaceX also won a Falcon Heavy contract for the launch of the Psyche mission. Our second news is based on Space Force General's opinion the success of private companies like SpaceX helped the U.S. secure the space domain. The U.S. has long understood that we are stronger with a secure and stable space domain. And all of those sectors play into that, said General John Raymond, the U.S. Space Force's Chief of Operations, on the 3rd of February. He also said about the success of private space agencies like SpaceX that there is a ton of excitement across America on space in all sectors. I've talked about people knocking on our door, wanting to come into the Space Force in numbers greater than what we have slots to fill. I've talked in the past about how universities are seeing more students apply for space STEM degrees, which I think is going to be great for our nation. On the 3rd of February, Wednesday, Raymond commented on the Wall Street and billionaire investment in the space industry that I'm excited about all of it, both what we're doing here on national security and what's going on in the commercial industry that we can leverage the advantage. The Wall Street and billionaire investment in the space industry has refueled the interest in space among all Americans and employment procedure become more resilient in the U.S. Space Force. The U.S. Space Force, the Pentagon's newest branch, was continuously looking for partner with the private sector companies for joint venture projects and also for investment into the space industry. The Pentagon is thoroughly observing the growth of famous rocket builders like SpaceX, Rocket Lab, Virgin Orbit, and Astra. General John Raymond praised SpaceX indirectly for conducting the NASA's Crew 1 mission, which was the first operational launch of SpaceX's Crew Dragon spacecraft. He said, "If you look at what's going on in the civil sector with the launch of U.S. astronauts, and in this last launch, a Japanese astronaut from U.S. soil on a commercial launch vehicle, there's a ton of excitement there." Raymond also showed his support for SpaceX when SpaceX announced last week that it will launch Inspiration 4, first all-civilian crew, into orbit later this year. Inspiration 4, the groundbreaking flight, will be directed by a billionaire named Jared Isaacman. The names of passengers other than Jared Isaacman has yet to be announced. Two of the seats are to be decided in public online competitions, which are to be conducted in February. The mission is intended for using in higher-class space tourism to raise funds for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. According to a report, Raymond did not provide any comments regarding to SpaceX's Starship SN9 rocket test flight conducted on Tuesday, which ultimately exploded in a landing attempt. Report says that despite COVID-19 pandemic, private investment in space companies set a fresh annual record in 2020. Our last news segment for today is regarding Viasat, as they receive $50 million Air Force contract. On the 2nd of February 2021, the Defense Department announced the $50.8 million contract with Viasat, a satellite communications and wireless networking technology provider. Viasat got this contract from the Air Force Research Laboratory to build up an extensive collection of prototype space systems. The $50.8 million contract between Viasat and Air Force Research Laboratory will cover up a period of 7 years. According to report, these space systems will deal with studies of these space systems and then designing them, manufacturing them out, integration of components, launching of those newly improved space systems, flight and demonstration of satellites, building up ground terminals, and other technologies. Mark Dankberg, CEO of Viasat, had said earlier in 2020 that the company observes the Air Force Research Laboratory's Link 16 satellite contract as an outstanding possibility for expansion in the satellite communications and space markets. Mark said, "The notion of extending the range of Link 16 through space is really pretty interesting. The advantage is that there are many thousands and going into the tens of thousands and potential for hundreds of thousands of devices that are Link 16 capable. And we have other applications that we've been working with government customers that do involve that involve either sensing or communication satellites in space. And so I think you're going to see us do more of that." Dankberg had earlier said, "If Viasat gets the opportunity to build a fleet of satellites to do tactical networking, then they'll be really interested to do it." And now they got it. U.S. military and NATO allies uses Link 16, an encoded radio frequency, to communicate information across the battlefield secretly. The satellites of Viasat will serve as a network relay for Link 16 communication system. Space Vehicles Directorate of Air Force Research Laboratory, based at Kirtland Air Force Base, New Mexico, is now working jointly with Viasat on other space plans. Viasat was primarily centered on geostationary satellite communications, but now they're expanding and progressing in other areas such as cybersecurity, network operations, and low Earth orbit satellites. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.